up, guys? Welcome back to Antics Garage. I'm Sam.
And I'm Brad.
And our go-kart is almost complete. In this video, we installed the floor pan, and we finished up the paint job.
And that's pretty cool. We've had some challenges with camera and audio stuff, so we apologize in advance if anything looks or sounds weird in here, but we're working on it. But in the meantime, check out the video.
Enjoy. Okay, guys, got some good news, and I've got some bad news. Good news is, we're going to start constructing the floor pan, one step closer to being done. Bad news, so now we have to take this back all apart.
Fun. We'll use lock nuts on this when we put it all back together. Did you delete all the old footage?
Okay.
Shut up, Ricky! Back axle taken care of.
Yep. All that's left is...
This is all that's left.
Front wheels.
From our once glorious, almost put together go-kart.
Now it's completely destroyed.
But it'll be put back together again soon. Yay!
Looks kind of sad now. With nothing on it, doesn't it?
It's like we're doing like... Part 2 all over again.
I know.
But, like, more done.
What? We need a floor for this thing so we don't Fred Flintstone our feet into the ground. I found this piece of some sort of commercial shelving stuff. It's really thin gauge. Hopefully it's not too thin a gauge, but... We are going to cut it up and weld it onto the floor.
A lot of the stuff we use in this video is scavenged.
We're going to use yet another cool tool here for cutting really thin stuff. This is a sheet metal shear, or sometimes it's called a nibbler. Basically, it's got a fixed blade here, and then this blade moves up and down, and it acts like scissors. And if it's thin enough gauge metal... Man, it'll just mow right through it. And I think it's perfect for this thin stuff.
Rock, metal, scissors.
Basically, yeah.
Clearly, metal is beaten by scissors. And you have an awesome springy thing afterwards.
Yes.
Gesundheit.
So this sheet metal is extremely rusty and is not cool enough at all for what we're doing. But here at Antics Garage, we have the technology to fix that. What's that?
Wow. How'd you do that?
Okay, so we have our frame flipped over and it already looks good. We're going to test fit our floor pan for the first time. So it looks pretty nice. We're just going to grind some of the paint off near the edges, and we're stitch weld it on.
Yep.
So this is basically prep for welding. We have some of the paint grinded off so we can have a nice, clean, sturdy weld. We made some slitted holes here so that way we can easily get to the axle. So now we are ready to weld them on.
Okay, we got the floor pan attached to the bottom of the frame, and we're only showing you from this side because all the welds on the bottom side look really, really awful. And this metal was probably a tiny bit too thin for this. I think it'll work, but if we were going to do it over again, I would just find a better piece of steel. But it'll keep our feet from hitting the ground. That's all it needs to do.
This is our final prep before we start painting. We're going to use the wire brush to remove all surface rust on the floor pan and everywhere else that just is still a little bit rusty. We also last minute realized that we didn't have a bracket to install our kill switch for the engine, because if we didn't have that, the engine would turn on, but there would be no way to turn it off.
Okay, we've got the frame completely done, all the fabrication's done, we got some of the welds ground down, make things look a little nicer, it's all wiped down with acetone, it's prepped for paint. We're going to prime it first, and I think what our plan is, we're going to prime the top side, everything we can see, and then we're going to flip it over, prime the bottom side, let that dry, paint the bottom side, and then flip it back over again and paint the top side. Hopefully that all made sense. We'll see what happens. This is a white primer. It will help our color pop a little bit more. And while we're not really set up super, you know, we don't have a paint booth or anything, we've got serious cross ventilation going through here, and we're wearing masks, and we'll try to spend as little time in these fumes as we can, so. Sorry, safety police, we're doing the best we can.
Alright guys, the primer on the top of the frame is complete.
We might have missed a few spots, but we can, we'll touch them up once we flip it over to do the bottom side.
And now we're going to start with the greenie.
Very, very green. Take time out mid-video for a quick product review. This stuff right here, don't buy it. It's horrible. It is truly awful. I think we're going to get there. The color is going to be okay, but this stuff is like almost translucent, and it just, takes forever to cover, and you just have to keep painting and painting and painting, and it's splotchy, and it's just bad. So don't buy this.
Okay, let's give the viewers watching right now just a quick close up of what you are supposed to look out for in stores.
Yeah. This is a big no.
What is in front of you, do not even consider purchasing.
Yeah.
Before we shine this up with a clear coat, just take a look at the color.
That is the greenest green I've ever greened before.
Well said.
Well, the green is finished, and it looks pretty good. We like the color, even though we don't like the paint. We like the color so much, we decided to just go ahead and paint everything green.
Now that we have our green done, in the comments in previous videos, we got requests to put flames on this thing. And we are not one to turn down flames. And we thought a great place to put those would be right here on the floor pan. So we're going to get some flames on this thing.
All right, we've got kind of an idea of what we want to do with the flames. I was thinking about laying something out in the computer, but I think I'm just going to go right to pencil on masking material and just lay it out. I can kind of refine it as we go, but I'm just going to try a couple things and we'll see where it ends up. I can already tell I'm not liking this so far, but hey, it'll give us a starting point. Then I can tweak and move and change as we go.
So we've been sketching and erasing a few flame designs until we find some that we like. In order to doing that, we're going to need a pencil, a sketching hand, and some precision eyeballing.
That's right. Precision eyeballing for the win. Okay, we've got the flames kind of laid out. Just kind of kept tweaking and refining them until we got a shape that kind of fits proportionately in the area we got here, and do a couple more tweaks, and then we can cut them out and start painting them. That is very satisfying to watch.
It is.
Sweet.
This paint job is chicken approved. Delta likes it. Can you say you like it to the camera?
I think that means yes.
These are going to be really light. Kind of a dusting.
Do not think that we are professionals. Because we are not.
I'm a professional at something. But it's not this.
That's the truth. Merry Christmas!
Yay.
A go-kart frame. I've always wanted one. We'll let those flames sit here for a couple of minutes, and then we'll unveil and see how we did. Alrighty, guys. Moment of truth. Oh my goodness, they already look amazing. Oh my gosh!
Flames.
everything but a tiny nugget.
Mm-hmm. I just realized I screwed something up, but that's alright.
That is how we learn here.
That's right.
Screw things up and figure out how not to screw the same thing up.
That's right.
Alrighty, guys. Our finished, painted go-kart frame. You guys, this is a beauty. We had hard-fought troubles with the terrible Rust-Oleum fluorescent neon green paint, but we managed and we conquered, and this is the finished product.
All right, that wraps up part 5. I know you probably wish we would have finished the darn thing. It's basically done, but the next video we are going to reassemble it real quick. Then the only thing left to do is fire it up
and take it for a spin. Thanks for watching, you guys. If you guys want to see this in action, make sure you stay tuned. If you haven't already seen our last video, make sure you click right up here so that way you don't miss out. Thank you so much. We'll see you guys next time.
Have a good one.